love.
There's that explosive backhand from Lim we talked about before this match started, Barbara. That's just too good.
What a great way to open the match.
Love three.
You feel so much pressure as an athlete right before the match starts.
Three,
and so when you first get out there, you'll notice Morgaard kind of unsure of himself the first 3 points. Fortunately, he got an unforced error there from Lim. That kind of makes you feel a little better when you're struggling a little bit to start the match.
Oh, beautiful touch shot by Morgaard.
That was absolutely brilliant. First of all, look at the arc of the ball, and then look where it hits, right on the white line. I mean, you can't do it better than that. I like that opening by Lim. It was nice and slow, and it had a pretty high arc. Table tennis is not all about speed. You've got to know when to play fast and when to play slow.
Three, four.
Let's watch what happens here. Oh, that ball. Oh, fantastic reaction by Lim. He is putting his hand up, so it must have hit the edge of his racket. So he's acknowledging that something happened, right? Watch this. Oh, I guess it was a little bit of a miss hit. It looked pretty good from here. Look at that backhand by Lim, and a quality forehand cut received by Morgaard there.
Lim is really coming out with all the power shots in this first game.
Three, seven.
There's another missed receive by Morgaard. He's had several of those this game. One of the quickest ways you can let a game get away from you is start missing your opponent's serve a bunch.
3-8.
And Lim showing that he can definitely return the serve well, as you saw right there.
Eight, four.
Well, Morgaard is clearly out of rhythm to start this match. I like what he did right there. When I get out of rhythm and I can't make my speed shots, you gotta back off and start trying to play medium speed and slow. You've gotta establish that you can put the ball on the table first before you start going for speed.
9-4.
That forehand cut that the Swedish athletes are so good at, not effective against the power of Lim.
Five, nine.
A beautiful banana flick there. That's the first one we've seen him try this game. He's been pretty much limited to cuts. Look at that beautiful banana flick for momentum.
5-10.
Unfortunately, not able to carry that through. And let's take a look at Morgaard's paddle. It's actually slightly different shape than most paddles we've seen.
10-6.
Yeah, just watching Morgaard miss that serve. It's not that it was that important of a point. You know, this game, chances are he's going to lose it, but it just shows that he's so out of rhythm, he even missed his serve.
11-6.
And Lim takes it that first game, and a pretty commanding first game. Lim felt much more in rhythm than Morgaard here.
No side tape. Interesting he has no side tape, Barbara. When I don't play with side tape and I make cuts and my paddle hits the table, it just chews up the end of my racket so fast. Without side tape, I just beat my paddle up in a hurry.
two.
Morgard playing very nice control shots. And a reminder that both of these players have knocked out the top-seeded players in their bracket, and so this part of the men's bracket is wide open.
Two, one.
Right now, Lim is a little too fast for Morgard, so Morgard is going to have to play more aggressively. However, the problem he faces is he's missing his speed right now. So on one hand, he wants to play slow medium to get into a rhythm, but Lim is punishing him.
Just like that. That's what you were talking about, Jimmy.
Well, clearly Morgard by now has to understand that a deep cut is not effective. He's going to have to come in and at least slow banana flick it, change it up. Oh my goodness.
Look at Lim's backhand.
Jung-hoon Lim, what a forehand. What a backhand, my goodness.
Showing that, Morgard showing that he has all the tools in the toolbox, too.
And this is the first time we've seen this from Morgard, to actually put in a powerful shot and put it on the table. That's a beautiful shot right there. Nice technique, great waist and hip turn there. Maybe that'll give him a little confidence moving forward. Well, he did figure it out, Barbara. That's the right idea. He had to come in and flick it, but he went too hard. When you go in to flick one of your first banana flicks, that might be a second one, go in there and do it soft. Just try to keep it low to the net, because you know Lim is just trying to pounce on everything. Give up an off-pace ball.
Two, six.
Lim is continuing the pouncing.
Morgard got caught cutting that serve again. It's not working. There you see it again. He popped that one up, but even when he doesn't pop him up, Lim handles it no problem.
3-6.
And an interesting thing about Morgard is the backhand you just saw him play right there. He flat hits more than anyone I've seen. Almost everyone loops everything now.
Again, another aggressive shot from Morgard. It's like taking more initiative from the Swedish side.
That's it, Barbara. Exactly what Morgard needs to do. He's got to banana flick the serve and get away from that cut. Now that was a fantastic shot, and he's not gonna be able to do that all the time, but it's okay to also come in and just banana flick it real slow. Make sure it's low though.
He has to go for that banana flip.
Yeah, that time he cut on his backhand, but Barbara, we know that pushing against Lim doesn't work. That one popped up, so he had no chance. But even if he keeps it low, it doesn't work. We've learned that this match. He started learning that, but he must not be confident to use the banana, or he'd be doing it more.
Big rally here.
5-8.
And Lim takes it with his powerful shots. It's relentless, this power.
Eight, six.
Lim has been so dominant this game. However, only 2 points up. Trolls is hanging around. Nice shot.
Eight, beautiful backhand.
What a shot by Morgard. He knows he's got a banana flick it. And so he goes for the big one, wins the point outright.
And that should definitely build his confidence for future returns.
Well, let's see if it makes him understand. He's got a banana flick everything right now. He hasn't won on one cut yet, Barbara.
There he goes. Wow, look at that.
Trolls Morgard with the big combination of shots. great job getting his body around on that forehand. Nice short stroke, great hip and waist rotation, and to go down the line, just beautiful.
8-9.
I loved that serve by Morgard. Haven't seen that serve the whole match. However, it seems like Morgard had already decided before he saw the receive he was going to step around and obliterate it. If he would have just backed off there, he had it.
Oh, look at that
9-0.
Block.
And this is just a great reaction by Morgard. Oftentimes I'm asked, did Morgard mean to do this? Watch this reaction.
Looks like it was intentional.
He did do that on purpose, Barbara. That's well done. Oh, what a step around. Taking a page out of the Korea Republic's book. They're so good at that shot, Barbara. Truls Morgard, watch that step around. What an angle.
And now he has the game point. He really turned the energy and the momentum around. And now it's up to Lim.
Fire!
And he answers.
What a shot when you need it the most, Barbara. Watch this clutch play right there. Down 10-9 and you come up with that shot? That's amazing. Point by Lim. He opened up with a nice slow spinning loop, built the point up, then went for speed when he felt comfortable, Barbara. He's played brilliant the last 2 points. You see Morgard there acknowledging that, really having a positive head gesture there.
Beautiful banana at full confidence.
Well, Morgard figured out halfway through this game he's got a banana flick the serve, but that's easier said than done. To actually execute it as well as he has recently, that's clutch play right there also, Barbara.
Well, 11-12.
Tricky serve by Morgard, and now again with the game point.
Brilliant decision on that serve. It is so hard to come up with serves like that when you need them the most. To get a point outright on your serve is absolutely brilliant.
Let's. 11-12.
My heart's pounding here. This is very tense for both players. And Lim answers with his own very good serve, winning outright.
Well, for Morgard, the good news is he's going in for the banana flick. Those banana flicks he made previously, he can't count on that. Those are very difficult shots. And so he tried the same one again. He had already done it like 3 times. So he went in for the winner on ad. Didn't work out for him.
12-13.
You see Morgard here really going into Lim's wide forehand on those attacks. It was a great choice of placement, and now again with the game point.
That's just a great job stepping around by Morgard. Lim was not expecting him to step around. He tends to like to stay there and play that backhand. So just seeing him step around kind of startled Lim on that point.
Another good serve by Lim.
And Barbara, what was Morgard thinking trying to push that? You've got to sell out with the banana flick. It's the only thing that's worked. And he still pushed it.
Again, I think the confidence, his confidence is wavering on that shot. And again, I think it's the confidence he went to push it. And Lim punished him.
And I think he's a young player, 19 years old. So this is something he's going to learn from this match. But right now, he's got a chance to deuce this up again. But he's got to get away from that push. He's got to sell out with the banana flick.
And he goes for the right shot.
14. Game to Lim.
You can't blow receives all over the room.
And let's see if Morgard can come back strong here, getting over the disappointment of that last game quickly, or if that's mentally going to be very challenging.
Well, he made a poor receive there. Luckily, it caught Lim off guard because it kind of went to Lim's middle and it confused him. I don't understand why Morgard came out and pushed the first two serves. Very surprised to see that. He didn't even attempt a banana flip.
Morgard looks a little nervous.
Watch that banana punch right there. Not many people do that anymore. That's a shot that I lived and breathed by. But it's really been lost.
1-2.
In this day and age, everyone spins everything.
3-1.
Lim doing a great job of making Morgard feel uncomfortable. On his serve, Morgard's uncomfortable. When he opens with the loop, he puts it in a position where Morgard's uncomfortable. He's doing a great job of playing chess.
3-1.
Let's see if Morgard looks for that banana flick on the receive here. Part of that has to do with what Lim's doing. Lim is playing a brilliant match tactically.
Morgard forethrowing his racket. You see the yellow card on his name. That's basically a warning for not good behavior. And if he gets another kind of warning like that, he'll lose a point outright. That would be a red card.
Yeah. 2-5.
Those kind of shots he needs to try to look for more to get his confidence. You spin it up low to the net, at least you've got a chance.
5-3.
2 points in a row after that timeout.
And I don't like that choice by Lim at all. You're up 5-2 and you start going for banana flick down the line rips and just give your opponent a free point. He's not confident right now. Put the ball on the table.
6-3.
Watch this speed. Look at that power. Beautiful arc on the ball there. That ball is so spinny. And good things happen when Morgard decides he wants to use his banana flick on the receive. Decent flick. Lim made a great shot, but it puts him in rhythm. Look at that reaction right there by Morgard. When he goes in with the flick, good things happen. When he goes in with the push, he loses the point every time.
Oh, wow.
The rally of the match. Two gunslingers going at it. Watch this point right here. What a backhand to finish it off by Lim.
Morgard being a little dangerous, kind of almost kicking the
7-5.
Table. Just tempting that red card.
Well, it shows he cares. He cares so much, Barbara, that he has a hard time containing it.
For him to play while being so young and also so angry, so frustrated with himself.
Well, I've been asked before, is it good to play table tennis when you're angry out there? The answer is, for me, it wasn't good at all. I tend to play worse doesn't mean I always played bad when I was angry, but most of the time it affected my play in a negative way. And that's a beautiful backhand banana flick over the table there by Morgard. You've got to stay positive. You've got to keep your mind clean of negative thoughts. It doesn't mean you're not going to get frustrated, but you've got to be clean out there mentally.
6-9.
That push into the net. Morgard's clearly frustrated. That was not a simple shot, but something that he's executed many times before.
Six.
Body language from Morgard says he's clearly disappointed in the performance of this game.
Lim simply outplaying Morgard at this point. Morgard's got to hang in there mentally. I like that shot there by Morgard.
10-7.
I've been wanting to see more of that on the receive, whether he does the forehand or the backhand. He doesn't have to come in and go for such pace right there. That makes Lim earn the point. Lim might put that through you, but he's got to earn it. When you put the ball low like that, it's not easy to deal with. That's a beautiful backhand banana. Put a lot of force on that one. Looked a little frustrated on that one. Sometimes when you get down, you get relaxed, and it's easier to make those kind of shots. That almost looked like he was just frustrated. He said, I don't care if this goes in or not, I'm going for it.
And sometimes that's the best way to play, but it has to be controlled.
A long way to go for Morgard. Being down 8-10 is a sick feeling. You've been there many times, Barbara. So Morgard right now, not feeling too good about things. Well, you may see some reaction from him if he hits deuce. I actually like to do this mentally myself. Until I reach deuce, you're not going to see me jump up and down and get all excited. I like to keep my emotions to myself and only use them occasionally.
He has to make that.
11-9. Game to Lim. One love.
One player I would recommend Morgard look to more is Jan Ove Waldner of Sweden, two-time world champion, Olympic champion. Four-time world team champion. An absolute poker face when he was out there playing. You didn't know if he was winning or losing. He was such a poker face.
Let's. 1-0.
But still had the same intensity, if not more, than any athlete in the game. Just doesn't show it.
1-2.
Definitely isn't going to show you much negative emotion. I mean, once in a while, we all break, right, and show a negative gesture or something. But Jan Ove Waldner, I mean, that guy, whether he won or whether he lost, his emotions were so positive, so smooth, so clean.
2-0.
Whatever happens in this match, it'll be a learning experience for both players. And I think especially for Morgard reviewing this.
3-2.
Play!
3-0.
Lim with that crushing forehand. Very, very strong third ball from Lim throughout this match.
And it's that cut that Morgard goes back to again, Barbara. I just don't understand it. He's got to know by now that he can't cut those balls. He's had zero success with it. Give Morgard credit for getting that receive on the table. First time we've really seen him go for a baby banana flick. I've been looking for that the whole match. So he got the receive on the table, and at least it put him in the rally. You cut the ball to Lim. He just steps around and puts it through you.
Five.
Credit the serves of Lim, giving Morgard fits. varying the spin so nicely. Beautiful serve by Morgard, going down the line.
Clearly with the momentum here.
This is a nasty banana flick right there. Incredible amount of side spin on that flick.
6-5.
And that was a beautiful little backhand half punch by Morgard. See, he took some pace off, went into the body of Lim, won the point.
Let's 6-5.
Morgard still going in for that cut, Barbara. Interesting, that let serve gave it up. Let's see what he does here.
Goes for the flip.
6-0.
And stays very much in this fourth game.
Morgard steps around, does the exact same banana flick. Watch this right here, doesn't put too much pace on it, but look at the placement into the body of Lim. That's what won him the point. More importantly, great decision by Morgard. And a beautiful serve. He had served that topspin twice previously, Barbara, and Lim punished it. That time he went heavy chop.
And now with the lead. Oh, and Lim making a mistake. First time. Maybe the frustration will switch sides.
Trolls Morgard with a little Jan Ove Waldner, the stop block. Right there, wins him the point.
Let's 6-8. Six, nine.
How good is that, Barbara? How good is that?
That's beautiful, and I think look at him looking much more composed, much more calm, and maybe able to think about those banana flips off the serve.
He's put himself in this position. Now the question is, can he finish a game?
9-7.
Well, that was a quality point by Morgard. Just too good from Lim. I like that play. See, nice, safe flick there, and a nice try there. A little mini stop block, almost made it. Gave himself a chance to win that point. Oh, that's just too good by Lim. It all started with that nasty banana backhand flick. Watch this right here. That's what causes Morgard to pop the ball up. And look at that forehand.
This is a mental test here for Morgard. Can he close this game? That's the first step towards closing it.
Well, great job by Lim to get that receive on the table and make Morgard prove he can make a quality shot. Morgard did it that time. Morgard has two chances to banana flick this serve. Let's see what he chooses to do. Positive. You can only focus on so many things at once when you play.
Wow, that's a new return.
Off one.
What a shot!
Lim totally off balance from that.
Jan Ove Waldner will be proud of that right there. That's some serious creativity.
And again, two in a row. Off.
Morgard went for way too much that time. He had what he wanted, but he didn't have the patience to execute the right shot there. Played way too hard.
Yeah, executing all the creativity. Chop walk on the backhand.
And credit Morgard for changing the pace and the rhythm of this match. Look at the stop block right there. They're scary to do because you've got Lim coming in with Mr. Big, but he missed it again. There's another one. Oh, well
done. Look at all this creativity coming from Morgard. This is very difficult. Lim has a rhythm, and Morgard is breaking it.
Well, Morgard has come out and absolutely changed the rhythm and pace of this match. First, those two insane receives.
4-2.
Then he makes those two good stop blocks. Gives him a 4-2 lead. Here's this last point. Morgard playing that receive safe. Hanging in there pretty good, but the speed and power of Lim ultimately wins the point.
5-2.
Now that's a great job by Morgard on that step around. That time he took a little off it compared to that last swing we saw where he missed. Still a high quality shot. He still went for a lot of speed there. Another stop block and the forehand finish from Truls Morgard. Watch this right here. The finish right into the body of Lim. Lim didn't even attempt a shot at it.
2-7.
Morgard coming in now for that backhand flick or backhand banana flick. That looked like right there, it was a little bit of a flat hit. So now he's varying his flicks. Sometimes he spins them, sometimes he flat hits them. He's playing a brilliant game. Oh wow. My goodness. And this is why Morgard was so frustrated early in the match, because he's capable of playing like this, but he wasn't, and he got frustrated, Barbara, and he showed it.
Turnaround for Morgard. Commanding lead here, game 5-9-2. It's like a different player showed up.
2-10.
Well, Lim has surrendered. He surrendered 2 points ago, so this game's a formality. In fact, Lim just decided, I'm not going to show any of my stuff anymore. I'm
That's right, you called it, Jimmy.
And he can't get happy about the way that game ended.
One love.
It is so easy, Barbara, to just take your foot off the pedal 1% when you win a game or win two games. Basically, the last game you won tends to make you relax a little.
One all.
So you've got to keep the same intensity that you would have if you lost the game. Now, the great players, they're good at doing that. Some of the younger players, not so good at it. I certainly wasn't great at it. It took me a long time to get to a point where I could keep my level of intensity the same whether I won or lost the game. Beautiful
receive.
Great receive by Morgard. He's figured out he's got to go in and flick that ball. He's got to live and die with that shot. But what he's doing so well is sometimes he's flat hitting it and sometimes he's spinning it with a banana flick, throwing Lim off guard.
Oh my gosh. I almost spit out my water. That was such a great shot.
A little oof tick on Carlson there with that smash.
4-1.
Morgard, very interesting, playing very quickly. Usually we see players try to play slowly, but Morgard has the rhythm and is going for it.
2-4.
Morgard's done a great job to get a 4-2 lead this game. He went on such a run that last game, it's so hard to just keep winning points normally when you win 11-5.
two,
you go on
five.
A bad run, but what helps to not go on a bad run is when your opponent misses a serve. And we just saw Lim miss a serve. Lim's starting to show some emotion here as far as nervousness.
Six,
look at this. I think Lim is getting really actually frustrated. This big shot that he missed right here is his weapon, and he has missed quite a few.
He's out of rhythm. He's clearly out of rhythm. And he's out of rhythm because Morgard is in rhythm.
Seven,
and
two.
Morgard has a lot to do with what you're witnessing with Lim. And let's credit Morgard and Stellan Bankston for coming up with this game plan after going down 3-0. He's been a totally different strategician these last two games.
Two, and a net dribbler to help Morgard.
Morgard just playing a brilliant game strategically this game and last game after it was really poor previously.
3-8.
For the Korean. He got one of those weird backhands back and was able to finish, and he hasn't done that very much in the last three games.
That was a quality point. Good receive, good job by Morgard, better job by Lim.
A really nice serve by Lim. And you're right, Lim is not in rhythm.
Well, this game's over. Lim knows it. He's pretty much given up. Let's see what he does here.
Oh, I think getting a feel for those receives.
He definitely has. We've seen him make the last two. Now, that one was just a frustration loop. He's losing. He doesn't really care that much right now, so he just swung. He didn't care.
There we go, 3-3. Jimmy, who do you think is the favorite here?
Well, I think Lim is a favorite mentally. I want to see if Morgard can maintain this rhythm.
One love.
I'm fine with that mistake by Morgard. That's the right shot. He didn't overplay it. Hey, it's okay to miss receives, but make sure you miss them doing them the right way. Credit Lim for a great serve there.
Let one love.
Seventh game, every point matters. Look at that chop block. Wow, that's such a good point, showing the level of play that both players have and the differences in their style.
That's just great table tennis right there from both athletes. Well, that's a good job by Lim, putting that banana flick on the table. That was not an easy shot to deal with. Better shot by Morgard, able to step around and get that beautiful forehand stroke in.
Wow, look at that backhand.
That is just clutch play right there. Watch this. Look at the power. Now, that's one of the risks of serving deep down the line to the backhand. Better to go deep to the person's middle, and he can't do that.
3-2.
And you see this body language from Morgard versus Lim. You're right, Lim may be stronger mentally, but let's see if Morgard can hang on.
Well, Lim has demonstrated the whole match he is stronger mentally, and now you're about to see that advantage come through in this last game. I'm not saying Morgard can't overcome it. But Morgard, we've already seen him react negatively when things started to go a little bit not his way. Easy to be happy when you win a point. Right now, of course, he's happy. Lim, rock solid mentally, doesn't really show you his negative emotion when he's losing points. You know he feels it, but he's learned to control it.
And
the Korean coach on his feet. It's an extremely tight seventh game.
And this is what game seven is all about. Up to this point, I think both athletes have made good decisions here. They're just both playing great table tennis.
4-0.
Kind of a mistake, maybe, by Lim there.
Well, easy to make that mistake when you go for that much power. When the ball's that short, half the table's out of play, Barbara. So even though it's high, you only have half the table to work with. Generally smarter to back off on that. Yanove Waldner would have played that a lot softer.
With that flick off the serve, we go to the changing sides of the table. And sometimes this is an opportunity to reset.
Again, I am so impressed with the strategy and the tactics of Morgard. Once he went down 3-0, he has literally played a brilliant game tactically. Rarely see him make a bad decision out there. Right now, when Lim scores his points, he earns them.
Lim's still struggling with that kind of receive by Morgard. Now Morgard up 6-4.
Time out, Lim.
Beautiful shot by Morgard. Loved how he took some pace off of that shot. That ball went high. He could have gone for an absolute all-out winner. He didn't. He played that medium speed, placed it instead, won the point.
This is a tough road for Lim. He hasn't hit one of those big third ball shots in a while.
Watch this forward momentum with that stroke from Morgard and some soccer skills right there. Sign him up. You know, the Swedes all love to play soccer. I've never met one that doesn't play soccer.
There's that third ball by Lim. We haven't seen one in a while, but he is bringing those all back. It's not over until it's over.
Well, a mental mistake by Morgard. Why is he pushing that, Barbara? We haven't seen him push for a long time. This is not the time to start pushing. Hey, if you banana flick and miss it, fine.
Oh, here we go.
9-5.
Well, that's a little lucky for Morgard to pick up that point. I think both players are seeing some deterioration of their mental stability.
Well, here's what was brilliant there is he pushed it short. We've never seen him even try that.
Oh, there we go. Five match points. Who would have thought we would have been here?
And it's the flat hit. It's the Ulf Tikkan Karlsson forehand smash of Truls Morgard that caused that to happen. He spun one, then he smashed it.
Here we go, first match point.
6-10.
The Korean stays alive.
Celebration of Truls Morgard, Sweden.
He's so excited. What an incredible.